Okay, I'm going to show you what I got here. And then a lot of you have yellows, so we'll talk about why I send out a yellow for you as opposed to a green. And then we'll try another one and see if we can get a lot more greens. So I'll pull this over here. Okay, so first from that view, you can see there's lots of yellows. There were only, I guess, got to get this out of the way, hide that for now, I guess. Just three greens that I sent out. Some of you sent it in, I haven't looked at yet, but let's take a look at one of the greens and then talk about why there were so many yellows. What are you missing that I asked for that wasn't on the assignment? Okay, here's one of the three greens. What's the first thing I asked for on the assignment? I asked you to label the coordinates of the y-intercept. That student did that and they said 0, 10 are the coordinates of the y-intercept. What was the second thing I asked you to do? I asked you to show the slope. This student is showing me that the output is decreasing by 7 each time that the input increases by 3. Slope is the change in the output compared to the change in the input. So I asked you to show me that the output is decreasing by 7 each time the input increases by 3, and I asked for the coordinates of that point, which would be 3, 3. I asked for a second point. The student showed me that the output would be decreasing by 7 as the input increases by 3, and that the coordinates of that point would be 6, negative 4. I asked you to draw the graph of the line, and you notice that they put arrows at the end of it to communicate that this is a line. It is not a segment. You've taken geometry, or I guess some of you are currently in geometry, but when there are two endpoints, that is referred to as a segment. Or if you only drew an endpoint from the y-intercept and one arrow, that would be a ray. So if you're going to communicate this is a line that passes through these points, these arrows are actually quite important in terms of what you're communicating. So if you had a yellow, was it because you messed up on the coordinates of the points? Was it because you didn't show the slope correctly? Was it because you graphed a segment instead of graphing a line? Now, some of you weren't even remotely close. And you just had a red and just said like, wow, you're really off here. The y-intercept is at 0, 10, and the slope is communicating that from that y-intercept, the output decreases by 7 each time the input increases by 3. We have another decrease of 7 in the output as the input increases by 3. Y-intercept and the coordinates of two other points on the graph of the function. So as you look at your response, it's pretty easy. Like here, they're not showing the slope. Here, they only had one other point. Here, they didn't show the slope and they're missing the other point. Here, they didn't show the slope. Here, they didn't show much of anything. Here, they got the coordinates of the second point incorrect. And that one I hadn't looked at yet. It's pretty tough. It looks real nice, but I think you just stick with drawing it is probably the best way to go. It takes a long time to use those tools and get everything all nice and put on there. I don't want it to take that long. I just want it to be a drawing. If you go like this and mark this point, they also forgot to mark the y-intercept. They didn't put 0, 10. So there were multiple issues there. But it shouldn't take very long, right? Here they basically had it correct, except they drew a segment. It shouldn't take that long to just draw that out. If we go back to my example that I was showing here, they must be using maybe a stylus instead of their finger. We're going to use AnswerPad a lot, especially in virtual learning. So you want to track down some type of stylus. They're very inexpensive. And so that you can write on AnswerPad as nice and accurate as you can, because we're going to use it a lot if we're going to continue in this virtual format. We had so many yellows on that we better try another one. So I'm going to give you another function, and we're going to see if we can get a bunch of greens instead of a bunch of yellows and a few reds. So we're going to try graphing this function. And whoops, just a second, I'll send it out to you. Okay, I sent out to you on AnswerPad a fresh screen. Draw the graph of that function with all the information that I'm looking for. And hopefully we have a bunch of green circles this time.